Hello, welcome to All You Cancerians. Welcome for your last monthly horoscope for 2014, December time. What is going on during the month of December and what does it mean in general for a Cancerian, for someone who's got a sun sign in Cancer or maybe another planet, a personal planet, or planets or an ascendant? Let's have a look. There are some things that are important. It's the Pluto-Uranus square again. It's Saturn shifting signs and Jupiter going retrograde. Let's start with the Jupiter. Jupiter is going retrograde in your second house. And Jupiter going retrograde, the benefic, the planet of expansion, the planet of meaning and understanding and of seeing the things in a bigger perspective, going backwards is not necessarily a bad thing. It's in your second house of value, of talents, and of money. So maybe you are thinking about what you can do to improve your financial situation. And if you think about it in a very broad way, it might be that next year when Jupiter goes direct that you will find a way to maybe, if you want that, a bit more cash coming into you, your hands. On another level, it could be you thinking about your talents and the meaningfulness. What can it do for you, those talents? And am I applying them fully or not? And also about what you feel about your own confidence. So you're standing still, which means not a bad thing, but just means that you are reflecting. It also shows, and it's that kind of month, of course, with the Christmas time and all that, if you are celebrating that. It also, quite often I've seen when there is activation of the second house, people, especially with Jupiter, even going backwards, that of the ones that you least expected it, they can give you a present. Or you giving a present to someone else, and that gives you a very warm feeling inside and a lot of self-worth because of that. Because sometimes if we give the thing that we can't touch, that we feel in return, is this very joyful heart feeling. It's in Leo, so it has to do with the heart. So you can expect maybe a special present. And I don't mean to say something very, material. It can be simply a card, a Christmas card that you didn't expect would come from a person that you might not have seen for a long, long time. Or you're going to do that to someone else, and that gives you a very warm feeling. So that's the Jupiter. Another thing, of course, is which is major again in December, is the Pluto-Uranus square. Talked about that a lot. And now it's one of those times when, again, it squares up to each other. But, again, because a lot of fast planets going through the sign of Capricorn, so conjuncting Pluto, which is Venus and Mercury. What does it mean for you? Well, it's very interesting. Your Pluto is in your opposite sign of relationships. I've been talking about that a lot, that, you know, relationships can be a bit of a challenge. Well, not a bit, a bit a lot. Because there's power. It's about you not taking other people's power away, not manipulating. I'm not saying that you are. Or it is about you not being too submissive in relationships. So you taking your power and standing up for yourself. That's what Pluto in the seventh is all about. You encounter your power through other people. That can be quite challenging. But now Venus crosses that Pluto and Mercury crosses that Pluto. And this is a double whammy, you know. Why? Because when it crosses that Pluto, it's very close to a fixed star, which is called Vega. And that fixed star Vega has the affinity of Venus and Mercury. So that's why it's a double whammy. And what is that planet all about? Refinement, sophistication, gentleness. So it's a very benefic, it's not a planet, it's a star, a very benefic star. So what does it mean in your opposite house? It means speech and communication, that's Mercury. That is going to be very gentle. That is going to be refined and sophisticated, maybe from someone that gives you a message that goes very deep within, or you giving someone else a message. But I think it's going to be someone that's giving you a message. Listen to that message, because it's broad from the heart. It's broad with class, almost, with respect towards you. So take it in and feel the intensity of it. And try to see their point of view, because that's going to help you with the power thing. If you're dealing with power issues, it's really going to help you out. But it's going to help you out by listening. And there is someone in your life, whether it is your loved one, or maybe a colleague, or maybe a connection that is very dearful to you, that is going to give you very interesting, intense information. Listen to it, because it comes from a good place. And that will help you for the whole next year, because it's so intense. That's what the Pluto Uranus square is all about. It wants to give a stimulus for potential to break through. So this is a kind of a breakthrough with you and another person. And there is maybe a tiny little bit of a fear involved as well, but you see that it's very authentic, you see that it's very true, and that says something about you. And this is nice energy. So, what else? Saturn shifts sign as well, of course. And Saturn was, I already mentioned that, didn't I? No, I didn't. Saturn goes into Sagittarius, and that will be your sixth house. And Saturn has been in your fifth house for such a long time. So, oh boy, I'm glad for you Cancerians, because Cancerians are very, most Cancerians are a very creative sign. It's a water sign and it wants to nurture, and it's very creative in its nurturing. And the fifth house is the house of children, it's the house of self-expression, it's the house of romance. And Saturn was there, which was hard for the Cancerians, because they felt that they couldn't express themselves as good as normal, or as good as they used to do. And now that's coming back to you. So the way that you will express yourself, that you will enjoy yourself, that will improve. And Saturn entering your sixth house is all going to be about the discipline of your day-to-day work, maybe a bit taking on less work, because Saturn is focused. So maybe instead of doing 10 things, you're going to do 2 things. And you're going to be very much looking at the quality of something instead of the quantity. It can also be your health. So take care of your health. Make sure that, and the best thing for you to do, if you're struggling a bit with one or two things, I don't know, when it comes to health, to be very disciplined, because Saturn is disciplined. So maybe you need a bit more discipline when it comes to maybe your diet, or maybe whatever. Whatever it is, doing things on a day-to-day basis is better than doing only something good one day in the week, for instance. I made the yearly horoscopes already, so you can have a look what that means for you with the Saturn there. But a very interesting time for the Cancerians. It's good news that Saturn is now out of a fellow water sign. It's good that you can, you know, have that feeling again, that if you nurture, that it is well received. Because you might have had, especially with children, that you were misunderstood. That your children say, you're a bit too... maybe you are a bit too bossy or something, and not that you wanted to do that, but now you're getting more in your element again when it comes to your self-expression. Now the full moon and the new moon will be the full moon will be in Gemini, so that is your 12th house on the 6th. So you feel a bit emotional maybe around that day, because some things become clear about your blind spots, but you are quite content and you don't show it to other people. And then the new moon, which always shows, English is hard sometimes. But the new moon shows the new beginnings, and that's also in Capricorn in your seventh house. So So that goes very well with that Pluto energy I just described about this message that comes across as a new beginning. So have a very good month, you Cancerians. Have a lovely good month in December. Wishing you all the best. Spread out the videos if you want to, because I want a bit more people watching these videos. Only if you want to. Spread them around. And thank you for listening. Have a very good month. Bye-bye.